Regards from Mrs. A.V. Das, PGT English, KV number 2, GCF, Jabalpur. Children, today I am here to help you out in the writing section. The topic today that I have to help you out with is article writing. This comes in your question paper for 8 marks. Is it clear? Now, what is an article? An article is a piece of writing that gives you information or tells you about things firsthand, either in a newspaper or in a magazine. Remember that. And you have to write the article in 3 or 4 paragraphs. See to it that you write small sentences so that you do not commit mistakes. Don't try to use big and heavy words in your sentences. That's going to help you out. Be straight, be short, and be very clear so that you don't lose marks anywhere. Children, this article is supposed to be written in either 120 words or 150 words. So, when you are supposed to write an article, you divide it into 3 to 4 paragraphs. So, automatically, they get 30 to 40 words in each paragraph. So, when you have divided the article into 4 paragraphs, that is going to be very comfortable and very easy for you. Now, what do you do and how do you start? I just told you what is an article. Article is a piece of writing that gives you information about any situation, about any happenings around you in the newspaper or in the magazine. Now, once when you know what an article is, be very careful that in how many parts the article gets divided. The article is divided basically into 3 parts. So now I am going to tell you parts of an article. Parts of an article. So there are basically 3 parts of an article. As you can see, the first part, heading. Second part, the body. Third part, the conclusion. I repeat, heading, body, conclusion. In between heading and body comes the introduction part. In between heading and body comes the introduction part. So now let's start. Let me tell you how to start and get into the article. First of all, you read the question paper very carefully. As you read the question paper, you come to realize what you are supposed to write about and where you have to write the article for, either a newspaper or a magazine. Then you start your article. First of all, you write the heading. So when you write the heading, you have got it now from the question. So you write the heading in 3 or 4 words, just 3 or 4 words. The heading is not supposed to be very long. It has to be in the 3 or 4 words only. Now comes after the heading comes the byline. Who has written the article? They give you the name in the question, by Sujit or Sujita, anything like that. So pick up the name. Now this you have to write for the byline. Byline can come under the heading, towards the left, right, after you've written the article, towards the left or right. This is up to you where you decide. I will suggest that whatever writing you do, whatever compositions you do, pick the left format so that you don't have to remember which side what you have to write. You decide in your mind that you're going to follow the left format. then you will write everything on the left hand side. The left hand side. You will write everything in the left hand side. So once you have written the heading, now you write the byline. After you have written the byline, you don't have to write introduction, introduction. But now the first paragraph that you're writing is about the topic that you're writing about. In the introduction, when you start writing the introduction, what comes in the introduction? So that will be in 5, 6, 7 sentences or 10 sentences. That's up to you. Very small sentences, right? Small sentences. Now, you have to write about the topic, perhaps where, when, whom, why, all these W questions. That can answer those W questions, and then your first introduction part is ready. It is simply, introduction is what? When you meet someone new, you tell about yourself and you come to know about the person that you have met. Simply, article introduction will be like that. Any introduction will be like that. Get into the details later on. But in the introduction, you have to tell the W questions, answer the W questions, and your introduction is ready. Now you switch over, after you've written the introduction, you switch over to the body. You can divide the body into 2 paragraphs, 3 paragraphs, or you can write a big paragraph also in the form of the body. Now, what comes in the body? Extend the introduction in details in the body part. Now, what you have to write? Types, causes, effects, advantages, disadvantages, merits, demerits, pros and cons, all this comes under body. And slowly and steadily move into the body. Slowly and steadily move into the body. Make small sentences. Correlate all the sentences to each other. Don't jump anywhere. Don't cross lines. And be very slow, steady, framing everything one after the other. Once you are done with the body, you reach the conclusion part. In the conclusion, you will give your suggestions, ideas, and you can put values also where if you want to, and psychological related to health, all these kinds of things, consequences, causes, effects. You can do that. Even you can give remedial suggestions in the conclusion part. I will suggest that you start your article with a punchline. Don't try to use heavy words. Once again, I tell you, don't try to use heavy words. But if you are comfortable using heavy words, it's okay. Otherwise, don't get misled or don't get distracted using heavy words. Go slow, go steady, go easy, make small sentences so that you make less grammatical mistakes. And then your article is ready. Remember, article is an art. You have to cultivate it. You have to develop it in yourself. Once again, I will say that article is an art. So that's all for today. I'll be there with you with other videos also. Thank you. Stay safe. Stay blessed.